All right, so I'm literally just going to continue with the class that we finished a couple minutes ago. And I'm going to go fast here too, but I know nobody is watching this real time, so hopefully you can just pause the recording and figure out what to do from the recording. So I exported the textures, and each one of them has its naming. And this is I'm just going to create a folder for each of them. Sorry, this might take a few minutes, but create excuse me. So you have this texture called ceiling attachment. We've got five of them here: color, height, metalness, normal, and specular roughness. So just highlight all five of those and just drag them into your ceiling attachment folder. And I'm just going to do this for all of these. Again, this isn't, 100% necessary, but if you don't want to be looking at like all these textures in one folder, I recommend you organize them into. Oh, sorry, someone's calling my phone. Organize them into all these folders. So let's make this one. Crystals, electrical underscore wire, frame, light, base. All right, so I've got all of them in the proper folders, and now we can go back to Maya. I'm just gonna get rid of this reference if you or this pure ref window. If you right click it and then go to mode, and click always on top, now you'll disable it. And let's set up the shaders. So, where did that come from? So, let's see. Here's how we're going to set this up. Click the hyper shade. It's this little ball here. That's going to bring up your hyper shade. And if you saw it when it first opened there, it had a whole bunch of windows open. That's the default way of viewing it, but I don't need to see any of that stuff. If you see that, just click X on everything. Except for this one. I don't think you can actually get rid of this. This is the graph thing. So just click X on everything till you see this. Drag this hyper shade to this thing, dock it here. And now here's what we're gonna do. So let's go from expand this group and let's just go from top to bottom. Okay, so we've got the top here. Now, if this isn't showing for you, if you don't see this, hold your right mouse button and go to Graph Materials on Viewport Selection. And now you're going to see your ceiling attachment. This is the shader that we assigned at the start of class. When we assigned the standard surface to each thing, this is what we did. We assigned it a shader. This is just a representation of the of the shader. Okay, so we've got our ceiling attachment Arnold standard surface shader. We've got our ceiling attachment textures. Now, I'm just going to bring in the textures that I the textures. Sorry, one sec. I'm just going to bring in the textures that I need. Okay, so for this ceiling attachment, I only need color. I'm just going to hold Control and select SPR, which is specular roughness. And I think that's it. Ceiling attachment, height, metal. So just these two. And now we've got, when you drag them in, you always have a UV place texture node. You don't have to touch that. This is the one that you're concerned with. Okay, and remember when we talked about all this stuff, the aces and all that? This is one spot where it's important, okay? In these image nodes, you have to set all these color spaces to the correct color space. And if you go back to Substance, click Control Shift E, go to List of Exports, it actually tells you what color space these are exporting in. So remember when I said that only color, where is it? Only color textures need to be transformed. And everything else, roughness, metal, normal, can be set to utility raw. Well, you can see here only the color map has a transform. It's aces, aces CG, and the height, metal, normal, specular, roughness, they're all raw. So let's go back to the hypershade. This is my ceiling attachment underscore specular roughness. Specular roughness should be raw, and this is already raw, so just leave that. Now ceiling attachment color, it should be aces CG. Let's go down to the bottom where it's at, or where is it? Right here, aces CG. You might get an error, but that's okay. And now we're just going to connect the out color of this image into base color and connect the, just because this is a black and white map, just click this plus button. You only need to use R, G, or B. I always just use R. That's the red channel. We're going to connect the red channel to specular roughness. Be careful not to connect it to specular. Connect it to specular roughness. Okay, so we have our ceiling attachment color, aces CG, connected to base color. Ceiling attachment specular roughness, raw, connected to specular roughness. And we're just gonna do this again and again. So click chain and hold your right mouse button in the, or click right, yeah, hold right mouse button in the hypershade and go down to graph materials on viewport. And now you've got your chain Arnold standard surface. And for chain, if you remember, the chain was metal. So it had a metal, we're gonna use the metal value or the metal texture. So we're gonna use color, metal, and specular roughness. If you'll notice, we always use color and specular roughness. I mean, at least for this asset. And sometimes we'll use metal, sometimes we'll use normal, but we'll always use color and specular roughness. They're kind of two very important parameters. Okay, so let's see. Got the color. I'd like to stack them the way they plug in. So for color, let's change the color space to aces CG, and we'll go out color into base color. Specular roughness, it's already at raw. Let's grab the red channel and plug it into specular roughness. Metalness, put this here. Metalness is raw, that's correct. And again, it's a black and white mask, so black and white texture. So let's grab the red channel, or G or B, and plug it into metalness. All right, next one, electrical wire. Again, select it, hold right mouse button, drag down, go to electrical wire. That would be this one, And for electrical wire, we just need color and specular roughness. Set the color to ACCG, and then plug out color into base color. Plug specular roughness R into specular roughness. Okay, frame. We will need the color and specular roughness. And set the color to ACCG. Grab my pen. Color into base color, and then specular roughness into specular roughness. Whoops, what'd I do? Okay, that was frame. Now crystal links. If you remember, the crystal links are, where is it? Metal, so we're going to color, metal, specular, roughness, and metalness, color, specular. Set the color map to ACCG and plug it into color. Metal goes into metalness, specular roughness goes into specular roughness. Crystal links, crystal. A lot of materials, but that's okay. So crystals was kind of a special case. So if your crystals was the one that we visualized in Substance by, you know, adding an opacity channel, that was just to see what it looked like. What we're actually going to do is highlight the crystals, the crystals shader. Click transmission and just turn transmission up to transmission weight up to 1. That's going to make it fully transmissive, which means it's essentially glass. It's a glass material. You'll see what I mean when it renders. Shade support. Let's go shade support, color, shade support, color, metal, and specular roughness. Metal, color, specular roughness. And we'll go specular roughness here. Metal here. Change the base color to ACCG, out color, base. Base color. And shades. So with the shades one, because we have a height, we have this height, you know, bump, whatever you want to call it, value, we're going to use the normal map. You can also use the height map in different types of setups, but for this one, we're going to use color, excuse me, color, normal, and specular roughness. Normal goes down there, color here, specular roughness. All right, so normal maps are a bit special in that they are technically, you know, gray maps, I guess. If you haven't seen a normal map, this is what it looks like right here. They usually look like something like that. And it looks purple. It looks like it has color information, but it's really just three different values. So normal maps encode data in the red channel, the green channel, and the blue channel. I can show you. Yeah. So here's the normal map. That's what it looks like. They're always like kind of purple. And you can actually see the pattern of the weave that we have, you know, right there. This is my normal map. Now I'm going to turn off the blue channel and the green channel. So here's the red channel, and you can see it actually is just a black and white mask. Oh, sorry, not a mask, a black and white texture, you know, grayscale. Now if I turn off the red channel and turn on the green channel, again, it's just a gray texture. And then let's check out the blue channel. It's very bright, but technically it's a gray channel. It's white and, you know, gray, black. There's no color in it. So these are just three different channels where there's different types of information, and when you mix them, they create a color. But it actually isn't, it's not a color map. So we're not going to set it to aces, we're going to keep it at raw. But instead of using just R or just G or just B, we are going to use out color because in this color it has the information from R, G, and B. In the click in the node graph, press tab and type normal and bring up this AI normal map. Now, plug in your out color into the input and the out value of this normal map into the normal camera. And that's how you do normal maps. This takes those values from the RGB channels and converts them into a vector, I think. And then that vector plugs into the normal camera. I don't fully understand the process, but that's how you do it. And then we're just going to do the normal thing that we've been doing. Shades color goes into, sorry, change it to aces CG. Specular roughness is raw, that's correct. And then we'll just take the gray channel, the red channel, and plug it into specular roughness. Plug this into base color. And that's the shades. The light bulb is the same material as the crystal, or at least it's glass. So we're not going to use any of those maps. We're just going to go to transmission, highlight the Arnold shader, go to transmission, turn the weight up to 1. And finally, the last one, light base. Light base, we're going to use color and specular roughness. Change your color to aces CG. And change your, don't change anything, just grab the R value, plug it into specular roughness. All right, finally, I could have chosen an asset with less, you know, things, but anyways, we've got everything set up. Hopefully doing this like 10 times, you know, has made it easier to remember for you. Because this is what you're going to be, as a texture artist, you basically, you know, more or less, you're just doing this over and over again. I always use the Arnold standard surface, and I just plug my maps into all these values to create the look. All right. Next, we need a light. So you can't render without any lights. So go to the Arnold shelf, click on this ball, which is your sky dome, to create an HDRI. Actually, you can see it popped up in the hypershade there. But and for this sky dome, I'm going to use the same lighting that we used in Substance. So this this environment was this Atelier one. If you go down to your shelf, go to this Atelier HDRI, right click it, go to show in and show in Explorer. This is the Substance Painter environments. All of these are here and here. This is what these files are. So I'm going to grab that Atelier whatever HDRI and have your sky dome selected. In the attributes, attribute editor, beside color, you'll see this little checker box. Click that. And then click file. You're going to attach a file, and actually, you can see a visual representation here. You literally attached a file to that HDRI node. And, excuse me. And for go to image name, click the browse, and then find this Atelier HDRI. There it is. open that. And here's another case where color space is very important. You can see by default, Maya sets this to raw. But actually that's not correct. I know because I looked this up that these, but you can also assume, let's go back to this one right here. You can assume based on this 16-bit and 32-bit images, TIFF or EXRs, right? This is an EXR. Set them to utility linear sRGB. So, I don't know why Maya does this, but Maya doesn't have that name, utility linear sRGB. Actually, in Maya, it's called scene linear Rec 709 sRGB. So, you could actually see it. When I changed that, it was at raw before. See how blue it is? And how weird it looks, how saturated. Change it to scene linear Rec 709 sRGB, and now it looks normal, or at least it looks the way it's supposed to look. Okay, let's see, final steps here. So let's put it into the view that I talked about before. We're not gonna see this top piece, but we're just gonna just put your camera somewhere like this, or yeah, something like that. And what's next? So go to view, create camera from view. This is going to create a camera from this view that you're looking at right now. There's the camera perspective one. Let's change it to cam 01. And if you click panels, perspective, click cam 01, you'll be looking through it. Make sure to lock the camera. Just click this little lock button and now you can't accidentally move it or anything. But if you did accidentally move it, press Alt Z. Oh, that doesn't work. Okay, it does something, I guess my GeForce thing is linked to that. But clicking Alt Z should put your viewport back to where it was before. So I am going to lock that view. And then hold space, click on Maya, and go up to the perspective view. And now you can see, here's your camera, it looks huge. Here's the asset. And I'm going to turn the grid off just by clicking that. All right, so what's next? I think we're pretty much ready to render. So if you go panels, sorry, I'm actually gonna go back to that view. Panels, perspective, cam 01. Here's my view. Click this button here to actually see what you're gonna render. That's obviously too close. I'm gonna unlock the camera. Zoom out a bit, frame it better, and then lock the camera again. Now, in your Arnold shelf, click this eyeball, and it should bring up your Arnold render view. Oh, yes, there's one thing you have to do. Press X, click this button here to the left of the hypershade. Scroll down and press the garbage can on this perspective camera. I just want to render this cam 01. Go over to Arnold Renderer and let's turn all these to 1, and I'm just going to turn camera AA to 5 or 6. Scroll down to textures. Turn off auto convert textures to TX and turn off use existing TX textures. TX files are useful and they are definitely needed in like a production, you know, at work. But for this purpose, because we're going to be changing these maps constantly, let's turn this off. We don't need to convert to TX files just yet. Okay, and I think that's good. Close that. And now click the in the Arnold shelf, click the eye icon. Make sure this is set to beauty. This is set to cam 01 shape. Make sure you're looking through the camera too. Sometimes that matters. And then click the render button. And it probably won't work. Oh, it works. Okay. A lot of times it does not work. So that's nice. Cool. So it looks decent. Not bad. And I'm just going to click this little camera and save that image there. Press the stop button to stop your render. And then you can close this window, or you can dock it if you'd rather dock it. I'm just going to do one more thing just to make it look a little better. So in your viewport, hold space, click Maya, and go up to perspective view. And then go to create, lights, point light. The point light's going to appear at the origin here. So just press W on your keyboard to bring up your manipulator. And we're just going to bring this point light into the light bulb because it's going to be a light. So let me just center it there. So just bring it up until it's in the light bulb. All right, and then click the eyeball again to go back to your render. Press play. And it screwed up. Go to exit this panels, cam 01. That's an annoying bug. Go back to your render view. Make sure you have cam 01 shape. Press play. Okay, it's obviously too bright. Let's go click the point light. Go to Arnold, use color temperature, and then drag it down to make it a bit warmer. Also, for exposure, let's go like -3. -3.5, and then turn that up, down. Let's make it a bit warm. Cool. So get it to what you think looks cool. Press stop. Get out of that. Space, Maya, perspective. Grab your point light. Press W. And then hold shift and click on one of these manipulators to duplicate it. I'm just going to duplicate it and use this manipulator, keeping it in the same level. Now we've got four lights. Go back to your Arnold view, press play. Oh my god. And then, oh, that's really annoying, man. Perspective, camera, back to the Arnold. Press play. And now you've got four lights. It's kind of cool. And I'm just going to get a little bit of a cooler, nicer view. I'm going to click this lock button to unlock the camera. And then I'm just going to orbit my view a bit over and maybe a bit more down because I think this looks like a tall building. I think that somebody looking at this would be, you know, looking at it from a kind of a lower perspective, like they'd be closer to the ground, something like that. So maybe I'll go like do something like, I don't know, I'm trying to get like a good composition, something like that. Maybe I'll put it over to the side. You can do, obviously you can do whatever framing you like, but I'll just lock that camera. Go to the Arnold render view. Make sure I'm looking through it. Yep. Click this little button to take a snapshot. And yeah, you can click back and forth to see the difference in your snapshots, you know. Press play. And oh yeah, I think that's cooler. Like maybe a bit more. I'm gonna keep this render going. Press unlock. Go a bit more. Maybe it was better the way it was. Yeah. I mean, either way, like both are cool. Cool. So the last thing I'm going to show you is that if you work this way, you can make changes super quickly. So I really like to get my assets into the renderer as quickly as possible. I rarely use, well, I never use this renderer. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with it, but in the end, you're going to be rendering in a separate software, probably in Arnold, in Maya, or Houdini. So you might, like, my philosophy is that you might as well get everything set up and good to go in the renderer. And now you can zoom in, you know, you can zoom in, you can look at it, and, you know, maybe you don't like how it looks. Maybe you want to change, I mean, probably you want to change something. And so instead of working in Substance all the way up until I get to the rendering process, I usually export pretty, you know, I get a base on everything. I export it pretty quickly. Get the Arnold, like get the Arnold set up, and then now I start looking at it in the shot or in the with the lighting, and then I make the changes. And you can do it really quick. I'm just going to show you an example. Because I feel like this isn't coming through very well, I'm gonna turn up the I'm gonna turn this to negative 0.1 just to get it to really show. And then maybe I don't like the color. I want it to be blue's kind of weird. Oh, that's maybe just like something really dark, you know, like really. I don't know. I just want a different color. And then change this color. Let's just make it like not fully pink, but you know, something more pink. More pink. All right, so I made the change. I increased the normal map. Control Shift E to export. And just like uncheck all of these and check the shades. And all I did was change the normal map and the color map. So I'm not going to export metal. I'm not going to export specular reflection, specular roughness, or height. Just color and normal. And now, here's where they ended up. And I can literally just take this color and normal map, and I can just drop it into shades. It asks me if I want to replace. In general, never replace files, but in this case, because I'm actively working on this thing and I know I don't like the way it looks right now, replace it. It's fine. You know, you're working on it. It's okay to do that. And now since I already have my shader set up, you know, all this is set up. It's already referencing, it's already pointing to these files. I just overwrote them. So now they're different files. And if I press play, you will see that the shades have changed color. And also, yeah, the normal map doesn't, still can't really see it. But either way, this is how I like to work. I render, I look, I zoom, I go zoom in, you know, what do I need to change? I go back to Substance, make that change, export it, overwrite the file. And just go back here, and then it'll update automatically. It's just, you know, it's easy that way. Okay, so yeah, I know it's a lot, and to be honest, this is like second, I think this is stuff we learned in second year, and obviously I've been doing this for like 4 or 5 years now, so it's I mean, I would be concerned if this wasn't like too fast for you guys. I just hope that, you can think about more like the methodology I use and maybe like the fundamentals. And maybe, once you learn more in second year and second semester and all that, you can maybe think back to like using this methodology or like kind of using this and adjusting it in a way that works better for you. You'll get, yeah. That's all I want to say. So hopefully you guys can get a cool shade out. Or not a shade, a cool light fixture rendered, even if it's just like a basic thing, with physically based rendering and all that, like even with basic textures, like I mean, let's be honest, like this looks real, other than the weird like things that are going on. It looks pretty real, even this looks real. So you can get something pretty cool, without having to go insane on it, right? Hopefully you can at least get, something like that. And yeah, I want to see your guys' things when you're finished, so you can send them my way. I'll give Phil my email to give to you guys.